You just got your first VR180 camera, Lenovo Mirage, Kandao Qoocam, Vuze XR, Insta360 Evo, or the professional level Zcam K1 Pro, or two red cinematic camera with very expensive Antonia fisheye lens as you see right here. So what now? You want to make better VR180 video content, and I'm here to help. In this short video series, I will go over the basics of VR180 post-production. In today's episode, I want to go over how to insert 2D graphics, title, or 2D video in picture-in-picture format like my recent VR180 video. Let's dive right in. Hey, what's up everybody, it's your boy Hugh here from Creator Up. So before we start, make sure you have two things. First is a 3D glasses, like right here what I'm wearing. They usually come with red and cyan. You don't need a fancy one like this one. A paper one like that will also work as well. The second thing is make sure you update your Adobe Premiere to the latest version. So if you have these two things, let's dive right in Adobe Premiere. Before we get started, make sure the sequence setting is in 180, 180, and stereo side by side. If not, your view will not be correct. After that, you can hit this button to look around and see 180. But that's just 180, not VR180. So we want to see 3D, you can right click VR video setting, and the stereoscopic view drop down. Make sure you pick anagraph, go ahead. And now you see 3D. Now go ahead and put on your 3D glasses and you will see this is actually not correct. The left and right eye is flipped on this particular footage. I actually tricked you. This footage is actually filmed with the Evo hand on top of the card upside down. So if you fix that, make sure that in your rendering software, you flip the horizontal reel to right to left to make sure your footage have the correct left and right stereo view. Another way to test your footage to make sure you have the correct left and right view is to actually go ahead and insert and graphic with the black text. And you see black text on top of the white background. The cyan is on the right and the red is on the left. After you insert VR planes to fears. And on here, the review mirror is also against the white background. But as you see, the right is actually red and the left is cyan. It's flipped from the correct setting. So that's how you know that this is not the correct stereo footage. After you correctly input your VR180 footage, now let's go ahead and insert some title text. The easiest way to insert any graphic in Adobe Premiere is to use essential graphic panel. So go ahead and open that. So here I already have some preset. Again, you can go ahead and purchase some preset or use a stock preset from Adobe. So go ahead and grab a graphic and drop it in right here. I actually got turned off VR view. When you insert a 2D graphic, like a title text, they are not 3D. They are not gonna fit right into your VR comm. If you turn it on, you see this is not correct. So first thing you need to do is to make sure the graphic turn into 3D. Right here, VR planes to fears. If the effect is not in your often use, go ahead and type in VR. It will show up right here under immersive video. Go ahead and drag and drop on top of the 2D text. So now you see that text actually appear on the left and right eye at the same time. If you turn on VR view, you see the text actually have no stereo disparity, so it actually is not in 3D, but at least right now it appear on the correct position. Also, another tip, before you insert any 3D graphic, make sure the scale is 100% and the position is in the dead centers. Then the next thing is I will go into VR planes to fear, remove all the feather, and then change the size. The scale is actually the size of the insert text. In here, I actually want to make it bigger. Before we add some stereo disparity and make it 3D, I want to position this correctly. I want to position the text on the roof. It's not blocking the window view. And open rotation projection. Go ahead and on the X axis, right there. So now it appears on the roof. It's not blocking our view. But as you see now, it looks kind of weird. If you look at the dead center, the text kind of like lean toward you. Sometimes that's the effect you want. You want that to lean toward you. But sometimes you don't. Sometimes you just want it to be appear flat. So in order to compensate that, you open rotate source. And in here, type in the exact opposite value of this one. In here, which is 18. Just to see why now the text is actually also straight forward in the correct position. Whenever you move the text x-axis location, make sure you compensate with source 2 x-axis position in the exact opposite value to make sure the text appear straight in your scene. So last thing you're gonna do is go ahead and add some 3D by increase the stereo disparity, as you see right there. And here is a time to put on a 3D glasses to make sure that the stereo disparity is in the correct 3D space or Z space of your entire scene. As you see right here, the text is appear on top of my friend Dirt's head. So you want to make sure the text in a 3D space actually have more disparity than his head. So in here, I'll say about 13 will look correct. The best way to actually see if the text is correctly placed in the 3D space in the scene is go ahead and actually render this whole session, put it in the oculoscope to really see if it's correct or not. Or you can connect your Oculus Rift to look at in the VR headset. But the easiest way to just put on your 3D glasses and take a quick look right there. There is a more scientific way to place 3D graphic into a VR180 video using Canvas SDK by Taurus Media Lab, but that's a little bit advanced, so I will save it for the next tutorial. Okay, now let's take a look at how to do picture-in-picture in VR180. And see, the next insert will actually have a video inside a VR180 video, and this professionally called picture-in-picture or PIP. That is a really useful creative way to bring the center of focus up close to the audience. Because in general, VR180 or VR360, the far away object usually look pretty blurry and pretty hard to see because they all film with fisheye lens. So you can always have a 2D camera to film the close up and put it in picture in picture and put it in 3D space to keep a close up view for the viewer. And insert video is just that insert motion graphic is the same. You basically gonna put in an VR planes to fears, add some stereo disparity in here, 10 look good to me. And then same idea, I move this original graphic down 35 degrees. So to compensate that, you wanna add minor 35 to make sure the graphic is straight. Especially for picture in picture 2D video, you wanna make sure the graphic is exactly straight on your frame. And you also see this is actually a nest sequence. If you go in there and turn up VRCom view, I actually have a mask right here around the graphic. The graphic is filmed vertically with a cell phone. I don't want the top and bottom part. I actually crop it in here. So make sure that if you want to do any cropping, any effect on a 2D video, always do inside a nested sequence so VR planes to fear will not create weird effect on your graphic. Now let's take a look at another example so you really learn how to insert graphic in VR180. In here, I actually have two graphics, as you see right here. If you turn on 3D views, I have a lower third on top of a picture-in-picture sequence inside a VR180 video. So how can I make sure visually this graphic is on top of the picture-in-picture I insert? So first, make sure that you can see any graph mode. So you can review that on your with your 3D glasses. And second thing is, if you take a look at the top layer, I have disparity 11. The bottom layer, I have disparity 10. So with a higher disparity, meaning that the graphic is closer to the viewer's eye. That's how you make sure that the graphic is physically on top of whatever beneath it, which is a video footage right here in the 3D space. The last thing I want to emphasize of inserting graphic in VR180 video is to make sure you don't touch the position and scale. As you see, if I touch position right here, try to position the graphic in 2D space, will create this weird warping. So this is not the correct way to move your graphic in a 3D space in VR180. But what if I just want to slightly move this graphic off the screen? Like right now, it covers our director's head. I just want to do that. But as you see, again, it's not going to be correct. The only way to do that is actually if you create a graphic in After Effects, make sure you place your graphic on the left side of the 2D space. So when it inserts, it's already in the correct position. But again, the easiest way is using MoGraph. In Essential Graphic Panel, of this MoGraph, I already built in position. So I can just move it like that and the position will be correct. So what MoGraph does is basically like just insert a mini After Effect inside a sequence, but you can change value on the fly. You can also do that with nested sequence, just like what we did on the picture in picture. But just make sure that if you want to move the position value of your insert graphic, don't do it in the top layer with the motion panel. Do it in the nested sequence or do it in Essential Graphic Panel with MoGraph or with After Effects. Thank you for watching. In the next VR180 post-production tutorial, I will teach you how to use a more professional approach to insert your 2D graphics correctly in the 3D space using Canvas SDK by Taurus Media Lab. I'm working on a detailed comparison to figure out which is the best consumer VR180 camera, Vuze XR, Insta360 Pro 2, or Kandao Qoocam, or E-Horizon. And how are those cameras compared to the Zcam K1 Pro or even Insta360 Titan, which is also capable to produce high bitdepth VR180 video with a larger sensor and larger lens. So don't forget to subscribe to this channel, hit the notification bell to keep up to date. Give me a like if you enjoyed this video and I will see you next time. VR Creator Level Up on Creator Up. We'll be right back.